It's time for our daily devotion. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ. In the book of John chapter 15 verse 7. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. A daily devotional ministry project of Cristuto Genobaga from passages taken from the Holy Scriptures with quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy by Ellen G. White. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ.
June 10, 2020. Luke 23 verses 33 and 34. Verse 33. And when they were come to the place, which is called Calvary, there they crucified him, and the malefactors, one on the right hand, and the other on the left. 34. Then said Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they parted his raiment, and cast lots.
Quotation from the Spirit of Prophecy. Heaven viewed with grief and amazement Christ hanging upon the cross, blood flowing from his wounded temples, and sweat tinged with blood standing upon his brow. From his hands and feet the blood fell, drop by drop, upon the rock drilled for the foot of the cross. The wounds made by the nails gaped as the weight of his body dragged upon his hands. His labored breath grew quick and deep, as his soul panted under the burden of the sins of the world. All heaven was filled with wonder when the prayer of Christ was offered in the midst of his terrible suffering, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do, Luke 23:34. Yet there stood man, formed in the image of God, joining to crush out the life of his only begotten Son. What a sight for the heavenly universe! Those who mocked Christ as he hung upon the cross were imbued with the spirit of the first great rebel. He filled them with vile and loathsome speeches. He inspired their taunts. But by all this he gained nothing. Could one sin have been found in Christ, had he in one particular yielded to Satan to escape the terrible torture, the enemy of God and man would have triumphed. Christ bowed his head and died, but he held fast his faith and his submission to God. Satan saw that his disguise was torn away. His administration was laid open before the unfallen angels and before the heavenly universe. He had revealed himself as a murderer. By shedding the blood of the Son of God, he had uprooted himself from the sympathies of the heavenly beings. Henceforth his work was restricted. The last link of sympathy between Satan and the heavenly world was broken. By Ellen G. White, Desire of Ages, pages 760 to 761.
Our prayer for you today. Dear God, once again, we approach your sacred presence with utmost reverence because you are our Creator, great and most powerful God, and lovingly you are our Father. It is amazing to reflect on how Jesus Christ forgave those who crucified him. It is our prayer today that you grant to all of us the spirit of forgiveness demonstrated by your only begotten Son, have extended forgiveness to those who crucified him. Thank you for answering our prayers because we pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.